culture, they would know how to balance out the wives. Not from a player and pimp perspective, but from a man and his duties and obligations and responsibilities to each of his wives and his multitude of children. So we need to uplift brothers that if you fight harder, you come home to five women. And we happy, brother. Come on, brother. Right? But let me go back into homeschooling, because schooling starts with how we're supposed to be raising our children. It's not about academics. I teach my daughter about self-preservation and how to be self-sustaining. And this is beyond what we can do academically. We need to give our children tools every day. It's not about them sitting there and you writing on the board. I teach my daughter how to live, how to survive every day. I let her know what she's up against. Our children don't know what they're up against. Who will be up against? Who will be up against? What's this? There you go, Shadi, the white man. That's she already know. Normally we would say crackers, but we're gonna turn it down. We're gonna turn it down. But anyway, so Neasia, what's the best way? And another thing we need to move away from is saying white supremacy and just saying that it's the white agenda for white supremacy, because we are not submitted to white supremacy. So therefore, white supremacy is not really there, because we're fighting against it. We're all not just submitting to the system and allowing it to happen. We're sitting here amongst each other in efforts to fight back. And the way I teach my daughter to fight back your opponent, when you look to the ratio of how war is conducted, is a 90% 20% ratio. 90% mental, 20% physical. When we look around and we see our people and the deficit we in, it's not because they're physically holding us down like they did our ancestors. It's the mental bondage that's holding us down. And that's why I got into the field of being a life coach and an NLP practitioner, because we do not have strong mental hygiene. That they think that we can't, or we just don't care, or some of us are lazy. And another thing we need to start bringing to the table is we got to cut some of these Negroes go. We can't save everybody. We can't save everybody. If you study nature, in nature, she kills the weak. We need to start removing ourselves away from Negroes who are submitted to the system and allowing this enslavement to continue, this 500-year bondage that this European has on us. So it's essential that we have to start having these discussions. See, what I'm talking about is not academics. I'm talking about basic survival that I teach my daughter every day. And the way I conduct myself is how I want her to conduct herself. I don't just be around any old Negro. When people see me, they guess my name. They got Nubian goddess or African something, because when I come out with my jewels and stuff, because you're not even allowed to know my name. You're not even allowed to know where I reside. Why? Because my temple is my only sanctuary away from white supremacy, away from the coons, and I'm not going to allow nobody to invade that type of space that I created for the better welfare of myself and for my daughter. Each and every day we evolve. Each and every day life educates us. And we got to open our children's eyes to the world so they know how to navigate. Because this is very much so the matrix in our children is Neo. But we have to ask ourselves, where's this, the lady, where's Morpheus? We're absent on the scene. So our children are being confused by an environment because they only see us up against each other. They think it's okay to have these goddamn Arabs in our community. They think it's okay these damn Chinese are in here selling us cat, rat. We don't know what we need. And if you're gonna go buy something, buy chicken wings and fried rice. Buy stuff you can identify. Absorbing knowledge. It doesn't mean that they're slower, they have a different way I'm gonna look into the website Engaged NYC. But my divine self said, hey, we built pyramids. I said, we are the Sambos, the black gods. I said, you know what? The hell with this elementary school. We're gonna go straight into college. I look at these black kids who are homeschooled, and they went from homeschool into universities fully paid. And you know why they're doing that? Because they steal the black intellectuals for white supremacy. Mm. When we train and educate our children to have them open up their mind, there's nothing that they cannot dominate and conquer, because that's what we see with our people. Beyond sports, we're still the number one inventors in the 21st century. Go get the black star books. Do y'all got any black literature in your home? Any black greatness in your home? It starts with history and putting in front of these melanated beings. This is where we came from. This is how we contributed to the world. We gave the world. Tell them about the greatness that we sit in, the light bulb, the heaters, the refrigerator. My daughter knows this, that even if you come from the project, which I do, we still surrounded by the black man's greatness. We have that, like I said, the radiator, the refrigerator, the AC, the black man, the iron, the black man. Everything you touch, let them know is of our glory. And we are the extension of our ancestors who were the rulers. And we are the rulers by divine right to be running this crazy dimension. And for us to be
stuff, and they lie about our history, so Negroes?
Oh, that's how we do the bad stuff in the world. Because she has a lot of bad
stuff. That's how we have dumb people in the world.
Yes, yes. Anybody have questions now? Questions about homeschooling, anything?
Questions about religion and how to embrace it?
Right.
It's about establishing the family and the community. That's
correct.
The most important thing. It solidifies.
Right.
Woman's family.
Well, from what I research, when it comes to polygyny, which I made a video about, it's essential that sisters come down and sit down with each other, because the one reason that we don't embrace polygyny is only because we don't know one another. So therefore, because we don't have that bond, we're like, I can't share my man, I can't share my life, I can't share my children with you. So my solution for polygyny, which I said on my video, is that if I was to indulge in the polygamous lifestyle and culture, that I would do it with my direct biological sister or directly with my biological family, only because we was raised with each other, we genuine and know we love each other and have each other's best interests at heart. Most of y'all say, ew, that's nasty, but if you didn't question what your man did previously when he was in the bedroom, don't start questioning him now. Focus on his kids in the room. Okay? but like I said, when I did the research and I asked brothers from the continent, as all as NA rides, that is based on a man's income. Now, when we talk about an alpha male, bringing money to the table is an attribute of an alpha male. Now, you can come kick that knowledge if you want to, but if all you can do is bring your drawers over, I'm good. So sisters, I'm not sitting here. It's up to the sisters to come in union of who you're gonna be expounding your family with, and sit down and say what your stipulations are, and then once you know what that is, then you can prepare yourself, you and your sisters can prepare yourself to be courted. Always have what you will stand for and what's your rules and regulations, because in nature, the woman is in charge of reproduction. Don't let no man fool you. Study nature, the woman is in control of reproduction, because it's our job and duty to bring forth a stronger breed, and that's through the strongest man. And the way we value a strong black man is through his intellect and through, of course, his career or his ambitions and goals. Now let's say a resourceful black man is not only what he can bring financially to the table, like I said, his intellect. Now let's say he's a brother that just got out of college, he got a couple degrees under his belt. Work with a brother. If he's an entrepreneur,
like he's going to get
and he needs an accountant, he needs a secretary, then it's up to you as his women to go back to school and get some vocational training and some certifications to get this business up and going. Because with all of y'all in the house, that means it's more brilliant minds, which means how can we not come together as a family, as a marriage, as business savvy people, as intellectual beings, and say, how are we not building a corporation if the father was here? What is it? A orgy going on? No. When we step to the plate, we're gonna have a plan together. So what I'm saying is, first be content with you, sisters, and see if you're open to it. I understand we wasn't raised like this. Trust me, I feel when I finally get a man, I don't wanna share him. But I said, you know what? Why leave another black child to be without a father? So doing that is a selfless act. You're supposed to do that as the divine mother, because as a woman, the family always supposed to come first. That's how the woman is programmed. And if you're not programmed like that, then we need to go back and see what prenatal vitamins your mother must have took with you, because a lot of us are lacking in natural abilities and deviating or moving away from natural order. Any other questions? Yeah, I get to deep. That's it. They say, get on out of here.
Yes. Oh. My bad. Okay, camera, man, hosting.
So again, beautiful sister, follow her online.
Melanie Sutek. My bad, I got Al. My bad. It happens. You know, them identity names, you know, whatever. Still got my cracker name. Which my bad, you don't get two butters. See, I don't even know my, So on that note, we're about to set up. We still have 3 speakers left. I'm gonna close out. We're trying to keep the ball rolling as much as possible. I know the kids are really antsy. If anybody, you know, let us know we got somebody in the back or I can run to the store while the next speaker's going on. If we gotta grab some snacks for the kids, shove a, you know, banana or paws or something in their face. Yeah, that was crazy, my bad. I am hood. I'm just Gina. So, all right, so Luke, are you ready for the next one? She's ready?
Yes, I'm back in town now.
You wanted to connect to the